Yep, Facebook.
For announcements today, let's start with this Tuesday the 16th. There will be no 202 Bible study. The Thursday, there will be no men's group, but women's small group will be at 6 p.m. Sunday before church at 9:30, we will have 101, as well as normal service at 11. The NECA box is still downstairs at the foyer, so please feel free to put in whatever food that you're able to donate. Thank you for praying for the mission trips, and please continue to keep praying and for it for next year. Right now, the food pantry is in need of volunteers. Please see Dean when he gets back from his mission trip for more details on that. The Sugar on Snow event will be coming up soon. Katie will need a lot of volunteers, so please reach out to her or Shelley. On April 28th at 2 p.m. to 4 p.m., there will be a downstairs family game night. If you're interested, please come. Please see Katie as well if you have any that you can help with junior church on Sundays. They always need people, especially with the large crowds of kids you can have. And as a reminder, the restrooms are downstairs and through there on the right next to the wall. And I believe that's the announcements I have here. Are there any additional announcements? Yes.
Katie's family has had a lot of trials and tribulations, and let's keep that family in prayer, as well as Mr. Carr's operation is tomorrow. So let's keep him for a successful operation.
Of course, yes. Please keep that in our prayers. And seeing no other announcements, we will go to the script. When I am afraid,
I put my trust in you.
I trust God.
So I am not afraid of what people can do to me.
I praise God for his promise to me. Perfect. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Are there any prayer requests? I know we want to pray for JT, as Jeannie mentioned, his surgery is tomorrow. Are there any, and obviously the guys, all the members of the mission trip. Yeah, my sister Sarah fell, JT's wife fell on Friday, dislocated her shoulder and fractured her shoulder. And she's supposed to be driving to Boston to take JT to his surgery. So, yeah, it's just a hot mess over there in the college household, so just keep that whole family in it. Yes, Shelly?
There's someone family with Stephen that passed away.
Okay. We're going to pray for Shelly's family as well. Satan's working overtime. Yes.
Pray for my daughter, Karen.
Anything
else that we need to pray for?
Pray for
my parents
traveling,
as well as just peace in the household.
You've lived up a lot of families. John?
Pray for Israel, what's going on, not only in Israel, but throughout our world right now, that there's so much upheaval.
Anything else? All right, if not, we're going to go to God in prayer. Lord, we're so thankful for all the blessings, Lord. Sometimes it's hard to be thankful when there's so many tragedies and things happening, trials and temptations happening around us. It's hard to be thankful and to feel blessed, Lord, but there are so many things that you do bless us with. You've given us family and church family, and you've given us the sunshine, and you've given us this beautiful place that we live, and you've given us so many blessings, Lord. And let's make sure we keep those in our heads when we think about all the things that we need to pray for. Lord, it sounds like there are so many families that are just being attacked right now. Lord, I pray that you will just be with Anna's family and be with the Holly family. Be with Shelly and her family, Lord and Ellie and Tom's family. There's just so many things happening and things. There are families that have not been mentioned that need to be lifted up to you, Lord. You are the great healer. You are the great physician. You are the healer of our hearts. And these tough times, Lord, I pray that we just turn to you, that you can wrap your arms around us and help us not to be afraid. Help us to trust that you work things out for those who love you, Lord. I pray for our world. There's so much turmoil happening, fighting and war and all these horrible things, Lord. But if the world would just turn to you and look to Jesus, Lord, this place would just be an amazing place to be. And I pray that you will just give people inner peace and give the world peace. What I pray for the guys on the mission trip, that you will just use them in a mighty way, that you will bless them and bless the people who are going to be open to hearing your word. And I pray you bring them back safely to us. And I'm sure there are things that I didn't mention. There are things that are on people's hearts that were not mentioned, Lord, that you know our hearts. And I pray that you work things out according to your will. And it's in your son's name that I pray. Amen.
Amen.
And so now it is off for me. So this is just a time for us to give of our money, of our time, of our talents. I meant to mention during the announcements that in the back there is a primary list or like a list of names of people who could volunteer May through August. So I just printed one out so you can kind of look at it and see if your name is on there and where if that works for you. So after service, I'll kind of stand in the back, and if you have questions about it, I can try to explain Frankie's thinking to you. But that's a way that you can help give is by giving up your time and your talents with music and serving the kids downstairs and serving communion and all of those things. So if you have a chance, check that out in the back. And there is a link on Facebook for offering, and there is a plate in the back if you want to leave your offering. All right, and now we are going to stand and praise the Lord. So please stand with us as we sing.
Thank you.
hang in there. Hang in there. I'm just checking to make sure everybody's awake. Get your hearing aids turned on.
Thank you. Thank you.
We're awake.
Thank you.
Thank you. Oh, you're welcome. So when we met in the men's group, I looked at Frankie and I said, you're going to Guatemala. Dean, you're going to Guatemala. So who's going to do the message? And they both turned to me and said, so I said, I can do it. So I'm going to share a message with you that's from the heart. It says, do not fear, for I am with you. My message this morning is to not be afraid. I ask you to put what you're afraid of in the basket, and whether you are afraid of snakes, if you're afraid of being in closed spaces, if you're afraid of public speaking, things of that nature, it's all in that basket. And I'll talk about that basket in a few minutes. So when you say, do not be afraid, I look at life. And life can be both beautiful and it can be painful. The beauty of life, I can think of some examples that I can share with you, and I know in your hearts you know that life can be beautiful as well. Whether it's the birth of a child, or seeing a beautiful sunset, or I wrote down finding your spouse. It also can be very painful. Okay? Losing a loved one can be painful. Being involved in a car accident, seeing people suffering in a war, that's painful. Okay? So we have a balance between beauty of life and painful things in life. So what does that mean when we fear, when we face fear, and we face anxiety? So being a school teacher, I always like to inform my students, and I feel like you're some of my students right now, when I asked you to do a homework assignment, and I saw some of you like, oh my gosh, I'm going back to school, John's asking for John. But there's a reason why I do that, okay? What you wrote down in your paper is that relationship that you have with what's in your heart or what you're afraid of, okay? And I like to educate my students with vocabulary so they can take those vocabulary words with them. Okay. And one of the words that I want to share with you today is the word anxiety. If you look in the dictionary, me being old school, instead of going to Google and typing it out, anxiety means intense, excessive, and persistent worry and fear about everyday situations. Intense, excessive, and persistent worry about fear about everyday situations. So some of us encounter that anxiety. I use the word fear. What does fear mean? An unpleasant emotion caused by the belief that someone or something is dangerous, likely to cause pain or a threat. This morning, I'm going to be referring to the Bible that I use. It's an easy-to-read Bible, so the scripture that I'm going to be sharing with you today comes from this book. Okay, so it might appear a little different than Frankie's version of the Bible, but I have Old Testament and New Testament, so if some of you want to follow along in your own Bibles, that's fine, or you can see what I have up on the screen. The first scripture that I want you to see is from the Old Testament of Psalm 46.
Just skip that now, buddy.
Psalm 46, verses 1 through 3. God is our protection and source of strength. He is always ready to help us in times of trouble. So we are not afraid when the earth quakes and the mountains fall into the sea. We are not afraid when the seas become rough and dark and the mountains tremble. research, and those three words, be not afraid, appears a lot in the Bible. And so, who do we turn to? We turn to Jesus as our protector from all those fears, that anxiety, that worry that we have. To protect means keep safe from harm or injury. Doesn't that message come across that Jesus is there to protect us from that hurt, that worry, that anxiety? Because he loves us. He loves us all. Okay? And that love is that agape love that we have for one another as well. Frankie refers to agape love a lot. Okay? I even have a close friend that named her kitten Agape, so it comes to mind, the love that we have for each other. So if we look at the scripture from 1 John, chapter 4, verse 18, where God's love is, there is no fear, because God's perfect love takes away fear. It is his punishment that makes a person fear. So his love is not made perfect in the one who has fear. Be not afraid. If we look at the New Testament, in John chapter 16, verse 33, I have told you these things so that you can have peace in me. In this world, you will have troubles, but be brave. I have defeated the world. Be not afraid. Okay. So when he talks about having troubles, we talked about this also in the men's group, that to wrap our heads around it, and sometimes I have difficulty realizing that troubles are a good thing. Okay. It makes us stronger. There's reasons why we come across our different paths where we're going to encounter difficulties and troubles. But that strengthens us. We just have to know in our hearts that things will be okay because we have Jesus in our lives so that he can take those troubles, take those worries away. And I go back to that word anxiety, the things in our lives. I ask Katie to pray about what's going on in the world. Okay? There's a lot of nervousness out there, and understandable. What's going to happen in our future? What's going to happen at my workplace? What about my health? Okay? Worry about your children. Worry about your grandchildren. So many things out there, but if we trust in our Lord, things will be okay. So I turn to Philippians chapter 4, verse 6. Don't worry about anything, but pray and ask God for everything you need, always giving thanks for what you have. I often think of giving thanks, and I'm so grateful for the life that I've had and all the things that I'm blessed. And sometimes I get wrapped up in things in life like we all do, but if we take a step back, we know that things are going to be okay. The beautiful sunshine, things are starting to turn green again. No more blanket of white. Okay. It's an amazing opportunity to see God's creation as everything starts all over again. So think of some of the things that trouble in your heart and know that things will be okay and those troubles are good for you. If we turn to Corinthians, the second Corinthians, chapter 4, verses 16 through 18, that is why we never give up. Our physical bodies are becoming older and weaker, but our spirit inside us is made new every day. We have small troubles for a while now, but these troubles are helping us gain an eternal glory. That eternal glory is much greater than our troubles. So we think about what we see. What we see lasts only a short time, and what we cannot see will last forever. So why do we worry? It's human nature to worry. And I'm not perfect. None of us are perfect. Do I worry? Yes. For some of you that know my wife, she worries a lot. Okay? She worries about being worried. Okay? But if we turn to Luke chapter 12, verses 25 through 26, none of you can add any time to your life by worrying about it. And if you can't do the little things, why worry about the big things? Now there's a rocking chair there and a rocking chair here. Okay. Some of you thought I'd probably be sitting while I was giving my sermon. The reason why I bought this rocking chair and the rocking chair that you see on the screen, I'm reminded of my mother. My mother passed, it will be 21 years this May. And I remember the story that she told me about worry. And she told me that worrying is like sitting in a rocking chair. Now, the more we worry, the faster I'm going to be rocking in my chair. The less worry, I'm going to be rocking. But when I stop worrying, when I stop rocking in that chair, guess what? I'm in the same place. So why do we worry so much? And so whenever I see a rocking chair, I always think of my mother and those kind words that she shared with me. Worry all you want, John, but you need to put it in God's hands. He'll take care of you. He's our comforter. No worry. So when we encounter a lot of emotional pain, a lot of physical pain, as we get older, I know I feel physical pain sometimes. We're not getting any younger, but how can we do, or what can we do to defeat those feelings, that emotional pain that we go through, that physical pain that we go through? And I refer to Romans chapter 12, verse 21. Don't let evil defeat you, but defeat evil by doing good. Okay? God is always with us. And I look at this symbol of a hamster wheel. Can anyone relate to this image of where I'm going with this?
Going nowhere.
Okay? It's almost like the rocking chair, okay? Sometimes we get caught in our routines. We seem like day after day, I do the same thing. I get up in the morning, I go to school, teach my youngsters, go home, do some more work, have dinner, go to bed, do the same thing over and over and over and over and over, okay? So we get caught in that situation where sometimes we have to take a step back and realize, what are you doing? Yes, you're doing God's work of whatever in this church. We all have talents. As Katie mentioned when we talked about offerings, we all have talents in this room. Okay? You offer those talents, but sometimes we don't think about what our talents truly are. So try to reflect on the fact that God gave you those talents. Close your eyes and think in terms of how blessed you all are, how you can impact someone in your lives. But then, of course, worry keeps coming up. So then, if we turn to Psalm 94, verses 19, I was very worried and upset, but you comfort me and make me happy. He is our comforter. So we have to trust in our Lord that things will be okay, whether it's today, tomorrow, 6 months from now, a year from now. We just have to put our trust in it. So, once again, I have another vocabulary word for you, the word trust. Firm belief in the reliability, truth, ability, or strength of someone or something. Hopefully our trust is in Jesus. I'll repeat that definition. Firm belief in the reliability, truth, ability, or strength of someone or something. We'd have so much less worry if we trust Jesus. He says in John chapter 14, verse 1, Jesus said, "Don't be troubled. Trust in God and trust in me." Nothing can separate us from God's love. Nothing. So at the beginning of our announcements, I asked the announcements to reflect when we say the scripture together with the little dot. This is what we all said together today as a church. Psalm 56, verses 3 through 4. When I am afraid, I put my trust in you. I trust God, so I am not afraid of what people can do to me. I praise God for his promise to me. Now, it's very easy to say that when people are persecuting us. And as Frankie mentions every Sunday, as Christians, we have a hard walk, but we know our reward. We're going to be ridiculed, we'll be made fun of, but that's okay. We know where we're going. We have to stand up for what is right. We have to stand up and show our belief in Jesus so people can look at us and say, what does that person have that I don't have? Well, we have a relationship with Christ. And he can do anything. He can take those worries away. So I ask you to put those words in this basket. So when we're reflecting on today of what you wrote, think of what you're afraid of. Put your trust in Jesus. Put your trust in Jesus to not be afraid, whether it's something very simple on that piece of paper or something complex. He knows your hearts. He knows my heart. We just have to know that everything will be okay. Let us pray. Dear Lord, I thank you for today. I thank you for the sunshine. I thank you for giving me the power and the knowledge of what was shared with the church today. I hope that they instill, and I hope you instill in their hearts that you are the one. You are the one that can comfort the worry, the anxiety that we all face each and every day. You give us so much, Lord. You give us the air we breathe every day. You give us the food that we enjoy every day. You give us so much, and sometimes we don't take a step back in our busy lives just to know that you're in charge. You're the one that can take hurt away, take the tears of sadness away. For you did so much for us, and you continue doing so much for us each day. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you. as Christ's ultimate sacrifice that he did for all of us. Just a little while ago, we celebrated Easter and the resurrection of our Lord. And I just look almost like the words that I said in the prayer, that he gives us so much. And he did the ultimate sacrifice by being nailed to a cross and taking everything for us. So when we take the cup of juice, symbolizing his blood, and we take the crackers, symbolizing his body, know in your hearts the ultimate sacrifice that he did for us. Let's pray that, Lord, we thank you for the sacrifice you did for all of us. Your everlasting love for us. Teach us to be loved. Teach us to be comforted, for we have so many concerns and worries out there, Lord. Let us just reflect on the beautiful love that you have for us. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you.
let us partake in this ultimate sacrifice. So I thank you for listening to the message that I have shared with you today. Don't be afraid. I know it's easy to say, but put your trust in our Comforter, that He knows our path, He knows our future, He knows your worries, your anxieties, your fears. Let's conclude with a final prayer. Lord, I thank you for today. I thank you for being our protector. Give us strength each and every day, Lord, to spread your word. Show us how to be even stronger as a Christian, as an example for the people around us. Lord, please start a spark here in Kingwood.